and hearing people use technology to communicate and interact with the world around them. The more prevalent technology has become, the more deaf people have been taken advantage of its uses.
Yeah, I use my phone a lot in both school and life, and it's very helpful, especially in situations where I'm driving for Uber. I can more effectively communicate the details of the trip with a rider, sometimes just by using the notes section that is readily available in the app.
Deaf people use all types of technology to communicate, whether it be email, text messaging, or instant messaging.
Yeah, in college in the early 2000s, it was great. We were using online chat rooms where you could have a large number of deaf individuals, up to 30 of us, chatting away, which opened up a number of networking opportunities.
Whether it's for a job interview, just to catch up, or for communicating with the doctor's office, I can use email or another third-party app to communicate.
There's a belief held by people that those who are overly reliant on technology see a decline in their literacy skills. But is this true? It would seem that those who are constantly using technology to navigate the world, in fact, see improved literacy skills. A study that compared deaf individuals to other groups found that deaf people utilize technology to communicate at much higher rates. It's great because you can use technology to communicate about possible plans to meet up, or to just stay connected, or to collectively support each other by sharing news and information all on their mobile devices.
My wife and I are the only deaf people in our neighborhood. If we happen to be looking for our son while he's out playing, we will use text messaging with the other families in the area.
My husband and I recently bought a house. It was great to be able to communicate through email rather than going through the process of calling and leaving messages. Emailing back and forth or even text messaging was a really nice way to open up communication to us.
I think technology has been very beneficial for deaf people.
Technology today has made a big difference. It's helped me to feel like I almost have total access to communication. Not just with other deaf people, but with hearing people as well.
Slang is widely used in text. Phrases like LOL, BRB, abbreviating YOU to the letter U, etc., can cause others to think the user's English skills are subpar, when in fact research shows slang use can in fact support English literacy skills. Is this true of deaf individuals? From a data set of students with disabilities, a subset of 1,000 deaf students were surveyed. We took this information and analyzed it with this question in mind. What is the impact of a deaf student's use of text-based communication on their English literacy skills 2 years after their educational experience? What we see is that deaf students use text-based communication to varying degrees. From those who reported using text-based communication all throughout the day on a daily basis, to those who reported only occasional use. Of that varied group, those who reported using text-based communication daily, all throughout the day, showed stronger English literacy skills. So is text-based communication really that bad? Well, it seems to help boost English literacy skills over time and can be used anywhere. For example, text-based communication can happen at home between family members. At school, teachers can use technology to interact with their students. And all deaf people, regardless of communication modality, can benefit from it.